one and all video game aficionados to the Starboard Gaming Channel. And today we are taking the Volvo 240 GLT Estate 1988, which is in the 314 to 350 PP sector. That means it's going to be the new series. It's going to be the first of the new series on Saturday. And it's going to be pretty much a benchmark car. Pretty much a benchmark car. Which I'm fine with. I think it has racing origins, so I think it'll be fine. But we shall have to see what I did with it in the garage, because currently it only has 127 horsepower, 140.2 foot-pounds of torque, and weighs 1,890 kilograms, which is, wow, that's about 1600. No, that's about 3780 pounds. That's close to it. That's not exact. That's just quick math. But yes, we'll have to see what I did to it in the garage. Front engine rear-wheel drive, of course. See you there. Welcome to the garage, ladies and gentlemen. And here I have the 240 GLT Estate. And it has 367 horsepower now, which is a mighty fine improvement from the original horsepower that it had. It now has 285.7 foot-pounds of torque, which is also a very large improvement. It also has 400 kilograms reduced from its weight. So now it's only about, what is that, 2,800... and 4 pounds around that mark. So that's decently light, actually. It took away, wow. Actually, if you think about that in pounds terms, that took away, like, wow. Wow. That took away almost 1,000 pounds. 900. That's a lot of weight to take away. But yeah, first we're going to have to take it to the track, which is Tsukuba. The track we are using in this series on Saturday is the Tsukuba Circuit. I'll see you there. Welcome, one and all video game aficionados, to the track. And here we have the 240 GLT. Let's see how it can do. Can do donuts fine. All good on that. Has the horsepower, too. But let's just see how fast we can get this thing up too. Nice burnout. That was nice. Warmed up the back tires a little bit. This thing seems to be, wow. I mean, you can put it into oversteer if you want to, but that's at lower speeds. Right now it just seems very well composed. And very little understeer. I mean, it has understeer, but it's for such a big vehicle. I think it controls really well, and it lets you put the power down whenever the heck you want to, without really sliding the tail out, which is fascinating. It seems like it would do that. Yes. Pumping the gas a little bit there. Sorry, brakes. How does it do on the straight? Sorry. That's not too bad. Seems to understeer a lot at higher speeds, so that's fine. There we go, there's some oversteer. From clipping the curb and basically throwing it into oversteer is how that happened. That's also my fault again, flooring it on the curbs. I was just sort of experimenting more though. Seeing if, I was curious to see if it would do it all the time. Seems like the only time it really liked to, It doesn't really do it on the pavement. It's just curbs and that little green stuff. I don't know what that's called. Should probably look it up. It's probably called curb too. Curb grass? Actually, curb grass might be the right term for it, because there's green. So I wouldn't know. Almost losing the back end going out of that corner. I could just feel it very, 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 very slightly slip. Other than that, we do have a much better line out of here than the competitor, our ghost. Much more straight line speed out of there, though. Reaching 100. Wow, was a ooh. Apparently what I set there was a very good time. Oh, come on. Oh boy. Yeah, he got much more acceleration. He guessed. Yeah, his ghost got some really good acceleration out of the corner there. Sorry that I'm coughing. Riding the curbs while going down a straight is also not. Ooh, wow. I did not expect that. Brakes sort of went kaput there. No, that's fine. Oh. We have any brake wear? I wouldn't think so. I mean, they both have racing brakes on them, so brake wear shouldn't be something to be concerned about. Depends on what type of racing brakes they are. They're a really good kind. Yeah, that was my fault again. Just trying to see if I could get on the throttle, on the curbs, and new. Ooh, we did catch up to him substantially, though, which is a bit surprising. Ooh, we got a better run out of the straight. And not a better run out of there. But wow. Ooh, we were able to slightly beat his run onto the straight too. Come on, baby. Ooh, no, 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 no. Too late on the break in there. I just saw that from a mile away. I refuse to break. Yeah, don't want to get out onto the dirt there either. It's just spin us out, including around the throttle. Come on, baby. Baby McBoozle. Reaching 118 in the straights. Come on, baby. Just make up a little bit more time on him. Oh, I've gotten it way too wide. Oh, jeez. Let the car just float. Basically, you don't, when you're out there, you don't touch really the brakes or the throttle. You let just, the car just sort of float. Because if you touch your brakes, then the brakes are going to lock up, and you're just going to, well, just go straight. If you touch the throttle, you're going to spin out. Or you're just going to spin the wheels and not really get anywhere. Let me get drift you farther into the corner. Ooh, that was a terrible run. Oh, and we're on lap 10. That was quick. 10 minutes, 10 minutes left, 10. The 059. Oh, then there goes left 10. I tend to do that. I just go, oh, and there goes left 10. Oh, well. Yeah, well, we'll have to see in the replay how this thing was. Hello, and welcome to the best lap replay for the 240 GLT. I think it was really, really good. I mean, it did, I know it did look like it was just understeer. The brakes were not very good. The brakes weren't very good. It wasn't really understeer though. It had a lot of front end grip. Like as you can see here, that's not a bad amount of front end grip. And it could really power it out of the corners too. Really just, I think it's a very good car to race, just for anything, because it actually does have the control when going through a corner to brake or accelerate and get out of somebody's way while you're racing. Unlike a lot of other vehicles, where you're just understeering through the corner, and even if you do brake, you're just gonna go in a straight line, this doesn't really do that much. If you brake in a corner during this, it actually brakes and turns. So, yeah, I think that is a really good car, and I do greatly enjoy it. It's very good through the corners. Its straight line speed is pretty impressive. I mean, it does have 367 horsepower, so it is able to get up there into the hundreds quite quickly on a relatively short straight like Tsukuba's, but. Yeah, through the corners it is very nice, and yeah, I think this is just a very good car for this track, which is a handling track and a high-speed track, but we shall have to see how it does on the dirt. I will see you there. Welcome to the Eiger Nordwind W Trail Reverse. That is the dirt track that we will be using for the 300 to 350 PP series. And it is just basically the same track, except it's reversed. Same track as the 300 PP limit, but reversed. Okay, now, let's see how it can do. As a rear engine car, what? No, as a rear driving car, it appears to, okay, yeah, I know how this one's gonna handle. That was quick. Oh, jeez, yeah. Here we go. A lot of horsepower. No control. Maybe I should actually try to be moderate on the throttle. Unlike every single other time that I do anything. Moderate on the brakes, moderate on the throttle. Oh, that's definitely the key. Moderacy. Bouncing off walls, if... Just because apparently if you... Oop, my mic fell down. Don't do that. Come back up here. Yeah. It seems like moderacy with the gas is really what's key. Or it just doesn't really matter. Oh, I have a feeling that matters. She's not key, but usually you can just tell I took so much more speed through there than the last time. Okay, well, control is the key. Apparently that little sidetrack works going downhill too, because that's what I usually took. Oh, no, hard on the brakes is not the key in this, by the way. Hard on the brakes is just go straight and not actually turn while you're moving. Come on, and then just a random flick sideways that causes it to go. So maybe the fastest lap will be the only clean lap. Hopefully not. So the dirt section is obviously gonna be, ooh. Unless we get some four-wheel drives in here, because once we get the four-wheel drives in this on this track, it's going to be much faster than in the 115 through 130 section, because they're just going to be able to use this track much more efficiently than these rear-wheel drive cars, and probably have 15 seconds on them, I wouldn't doubt. I don't want to use it. Come on. Very key that when you that you know when to open up, which is not opening up and going through corners or other very dangerous maneuvers. There we go. Really being important on the throttle. Come on. Come on, let's focus and get this safely through it. Oh, I'm gonna hit the wall. Don't smile now. Come on, baby. It's almost like a truck. That shadow I'm watching, it's so high, it's almost like a stinking SUV. Honestly, it probably could be considered one. Definitely not taking the 71 mph speed up here that is needed. Don't spin me out. Oh, okay. You know when a spin's coming. So when you hit the back end of the car on those rails, and it's very, very hard to not stop it from basically twisting around, grabbing the front, and then spinning out the vehicle. Ooh, I'm gonna sneeze. That is not good. Ooh. I was able to suppress it through the pain, but now I'm crying. Oh boy. Or tearing up at least. Come on. It really might be your fastest lap. Which I'd be fine with. I think it's a good lap. And oh boy. Come on. Oh. Oh no, we snagged it. There goes the seventh lap. Stinking grippy walls. And like they're the strongest fences in the world. Yeah, look at they just propelled a car. 2,800-pound car. Which is even a 85 Mustang. Maybe 85 Mustang's probably what? 2,500? Probably. Small little two-seater. This is a big old station wagon. Okay. Oh yeah. I think this is doing pretty well. Of course, it has a terrible brakes. But everything seems to have terrible brakes on dirt. Well, actually, no, that's not true. The dirt vehicles don't have terrible brakes on dirt. Not the way I wanted to go. Okay, I'm back. Sorry about that. That was interesting. My mic fell. Because, well, the mic isn't actually technically supposed to go with the stand I got. So, it's a little bit backwoodsy attached. Still works though. Still works fine. But yeah, that was peculiar. Yeah, it appears that that was. Now I just have a screw with my mic. That's funny. That shows you how much money I have. I'm kidding. Come on, baby. Much less speed onto the straight here. Let's see if we can make up for that in any way. Oh, let's see if we can spin out for that anyway. How many more times can we spin out? Seems like during it, maybe the tires actually do wear down. I don't think seems like our tires would wear down pretty quickly, wouldn't they? It's not like they got that sticky stuff. Because if they had that sticky stuff on their tires. Well, if they were like racing soft tires, then everything would just stick to them. All the dirt and grime and stuff wouldn't actually stick to the track. It'd be sticking to everything that's on the surface and not really letting it go anywhere. Yeah, that'd be unfortunate. What this needs is spikes. Just need spikes on the tires. Like super hard off-road, those big old rip everything to shred spikes. Yeah, I think those might give it a little bit too much grip off-road. Just jamming into the ground. Sure would put a lot on the vehicles to have those on there though, because it might even just mess up the car just having them on. Sorry. I said I was gonna sneeze. I wonder why I sneezed. I don't sneeze that much during these recordings. So I wonder what it is in here that I'm allergic to. Maybe there's a bunch of dust in this mic. From not uploading videos for so long. Well, that's really sad. That's probably true. But honestly, I think this is a very good car. Oop, oop. Come on. Surely you can do better than that. For the pessimistic racer. Come on. Here we go. Oh, this is lap 11. Why am I still going? Oops. Okay, now let's go to the replay and see how it did. Welcome to the dirt best lap replay for the Volvo 240 GLT. I think this did pretty well for a base car that is rear wheel drive. For something rear-wheel drive, I think it did well, because it really was not, it was pretty easy to control, and it didn't really go into that many bouts of oversteer as some of the other cars have. And it was also terrible on the brakes and understeer heavy. But I don't really have many problems with the oversteer. Sometimes I actually had difficulty getting it into oversteer when I wanted it to, which I think is ironic. But yes, you could just see understeering for miles there. Probably would have been a little bit more efficient to drift it through the corner, maybe? I wouldn't know. It's completely up to chance. It depends on how you drift it through the corner, drift through there cleanly, or how you understeer it through the corner. It's all up to chance. But yes, it is. I think it set a pretty good time. I did neglect to mention in the speedrun best lap replay what the time on Tsukuba's circuit was. It was a 0:59.178. So that's a pretty good stinking time. On here, it was a 1:20.433. But now we have to go see what top speed it can set. Welcome to Special Stage Route 10, ladies and gentlemen, and here I have the 240 GLT. We're going to see how high of a top speed it can set, or how fast it can go. Yeah. So far, it's already struggling. Getting past up to 150, 155, 156, 157, 158, 159, 160, 180, 161, 162. It in the 300 PP thing, it's already past the I think we're gonna have to shift up into well, let's not shift just yet. Wait for it to reach 178 when going downhill and then we're shift. See how it does. Come on. Okay, so the speed that I got was a 186. So 186, that's pretty good benchmark time, I think. It's definitely going to be the one of the best for the vehicle classes in general. But, yeah, not really sure how that's going to be. I mean, it has 367 horsepower, so it's pretty much just the horsepower to beat. But we shall have to find out on the next car that runs this lap, this series. Well, it's been a fantabulous time, and I will see you all in the next one. Peace.